Brian Patrick Carroll, known as Buckethead, is known for not only his innovative and superior guitar playing, but also the fact that he wears not only a bucket, but a KFC bucket in his head while playing live, hence why he's called Buckethead. He plays all different types of music genres and has played with various artists, a few being Bootsy Collins, Iggy Pop, Les Claypool, and he's a member of Guns N' Roses during 2000-2004 and recorded in the studio for their album Chinese Democracy. He has played for a multitude of large motion pictures, including Mortal Kombat, Saw 2, and a Power Rangers movie. Let's briefly explore this guitar player's career and how he became the infamous Buckethead. After Buckethead left his band Class X in 1988, he would enter a song named Brazos into a Guitar Player magazine contest. The magazine would compliment him for his, quote, Paul Gilbert speed and accuracy filtered through very kinky harmonic sensibilities. Interesting use of words there. The same magazine editor would encourage him to make the most of his talent later on, and they'd become friends. Buckethead's song Sui got another honorable mention in another song contest. The song mentioned earlier, Brazos, would be released in the 1991 demo tape of his band Deli Creeps titled Tribal Rights. Buckethead released his debut album Buckethead Land on John Zorn's record label in 1992. The record would receive positive reviews and earned attention in the media. In 1993, Buckethead would audition to play with Red Hot Chili Peppers. He'd be looked over for the role, and he released his 1994 album Dreamatorium under Death Cube K. Death Cube K is Buckethead's more dark persona. He wears a black chrome mask similar to Darth Vader. He would release his second studio album under the name Buckethead titled Giant Robot, which came with features from popular artists. The name would come from the Japanese series Johnny Sacco and his Flying Robot. He would release two albums with Praxis named Sacrifice and Metatron. In 1995, Buckethead would contribute to the album Octave of the Holy Innocents and would contribute to several movie soundtracks, notably Mortal Kombat. In 1996, he would release his album The Day of the Robot. This album was printed in small quantities and is a collector's item now. Several Sega Saturn TV ads would feature music performed by him. In 1997, it was revealed that he would begin to work on Buckethead Plays Disney, an album where he presumably plays Disney tracks. On his website, it read, "The highly anticipated album, once listed in an Avant catalog, has yet to be completed. It is Buckethead's most precious personal project, so he won't record or release it until he knows he's ready." He'd continue to collaborate with other bands and would release an album titled Disembodied under Death Cube K. Buckethead released his fifth album, Monsters and Robots, with Les Claypool in 1999, which is still the best-selling album of his whole career. Buckethead would really go mainstream after joining classic rock band Guns N' Roses in 2000, after Axl Rose would clean the band out to begin new. He recorded the album Chinese Democracy with the band. This was their first album containing original material since 1991's Use Your Illusion, which contained hits like November Rain, Double Talk and Jive, and others. We don't discuss the album in 1993. Buckethead's guitar solo on There Was a Time received acclaim from publications, some saying it was one of the best solos of the decade. During his time in Guns N' Roses, Buckethead released his sixth studio album, Somewhere Over the Slaughterhouse, and would continue to collaborate with other bands and work on side projects while touring with Guns N' Roses in 2001-2002. Buckethead would release three studio albums in 2002, Funnel Weaver, Bermuda Triangle, and Electric Tears. Buckethead would release a sequel to his debut album, Buckethead Land 2. 2004 was an interesting year for the guitar player. During January, he would leave Guns N' Roses without telling anyone and rejoin in February. In March, he would then again leave the band, but this time publicly, with his manager citing the band's inability to complete an album or tour. He would release three new studio albums, Island of Lost Minds, Population Override, and The Cuckoo Clocks of Hell. During this year, Ozzy Osbourne would also offer Buckethead the opportunity to play guitar in the band at Ozfest, although Ozzy would change his mind after meeting him and realizing he wouldn't remove the Buckethead costume, saying he's a great guitar player, but he wouldn't take off the costume, even in a private room with Ozzy. In 2005, Buckethead released the album Enter the Chicken. This album tends to lean more towards typical song structures more than with past records, but still maintains the Buckethead sound. His song Three Fingers would end up being used in the popular movie franchise for the second film, Saw 2. Buckethead would continue to collaborate with other artists. That's the main key you have to realize with Buckethead, is when he's not writing his own stuff, he's with another musician or band. He's always writing material. In 2006, Guitar Hero 2 would be released, featuring one of Buckethead's biggest songs, Jordan. This is the only time we hear a full studio recording of this song would be in the game. When he'd perform this song live, it was always just a verse and chorus, and he would transition to the next. But the game contained a special solo made specifically for the game. Buckethead would continue this year to work with other bands and release DVDs. In 2007, the guitarist would release a box set titled In Search of The, containing 13 albums of new original material. He would go on to release more solo albums and would release the popular song Soothsayer this year as well. Buckethead's aforementioned alter ego would release two albums in 2007 and a 5-CD box set. He'd continue to work with bands and other projects. In 2008, 4 years after he helped record it, finally Chinese Democracy with Guns N' Roses would be released. He appeared on all of the two songs and was giving writing credits for Shackler's Revenge. He'd work with Gibson to release the Buckethead signature Les Paul guitar, which has since been discontinued, but you can find it on music resale sites for north of $5,000. Buckethead would enter therapy for a few months and would return and continue to work with other bands. Buckethead would continue his career by releasing 60 to 120 albums a year in 2015-16, both solo and with other artists. He'd focus on his album series called Pikes, where the album title would be Pikes and then a random number. He'd participate in a Michael Jackson tribute band, and he would continue touring through 2019 and then COVID would strike, putting the guitarist on hold. Buckethead has influenced a lot of guitarists and also scratched a lot of heads with his insane guitar playing. If you'd like to know more about the Buckethead history, let me know in the comments and I'll make an extension of this video. I skipped the decades, so there's still a lot of material I could cover. Let me know as well who you'd like to see next. The legend of the KFC Bucket will live on forever.